So how to fix PHP update required. Well, you've woken up this morning, you've logged into your WordPress website, and now you see this large box here that says PHP update required. What do you do? Do you just minimize it? Well, obviously that's not going to get rid of the problem. And the reason why PHP is updated from time to time is basically PHP is the code that runs WordPress on your server. And your server from time to time will get new updates of PHP, which means that the performance of your website will improve. So we're going to show you this is no problem at all. It's a really easy fix, and within a few minutes you'll have this this totally gone, and we'll show you exactly, walk you through how to do that. So I'm Zane from Zanet Design, and I've used my 20 years of experience working with designers and websites and small businesses and entrepreneurs, helping them to grow their business on the web. So if you haven't subscribed already, if you know that you'll find these types of tutorials and other ones with SiteKit, Google Search Console, learning a bit more about how to use plugins to speed up your website, or just understanding a bit more about how to make websites work with clients, then make sure you subscribe below in the bottom right hand corner. And if you click the bell, it'll notify you of the next update. And I do regularly produce videos like this. So let's take this situation in hand then. PHP update required. How can we fix it? Well, if you have your website and you then have access to your control panel, then it's pretty straightforward. If you don't, then you'll need to just ask the person that hosts your website to provide you with a login detail for what's known as a cPanel. cPanel or control panel. And to go into the cPanel, you simply just do a / cPanel, and it takes you through to your cPanel settings. So you log in, and you'll be then given this kind of what it is in effect. It's a front end to your server. Now you may have various icons depending on how much power you've been given, but one of the things that they will provide you with, because this is a very basic thing that everyone is entitled to have, is the ability to update their PHP. And all you do is you just go down to make sure you've got that. So if you look through, you'll see here under software, select PHP version. If you click on that, and all this does is it basically just says that the language that your website will run on, it will say the current version, and then you'll see whether there's an updated version. So as we go into here now, my current version is just being worked out. My PHP version as well will be provided. And I would presume that because of that warning, there'll be an updated version to look at. So let's have a look. Okay, so there we have version 5.6, which was a stable version, which was probably a few years ago now, 3 or 4 years ago. And look at this, there's been quite a few updates since then, and 7.3 is the latest version. Now, I will say that just to cover my back, if you haven't backed up for a while, you need to back up before you do this. So just do a backup on your website just in case. But, and this is the best bit, if anything goes wrong when you go to a new version of PHP 7.3, for example, you can come back into here, so keep this window open, and you can go back to 5.6 and it will continue to resume. So it doesn't change any of your files on your server, it just changes the way in which your server runs. So I'm going to put it to 7.3 and I'm going to set that as the current, and that's it. You've now restored your latest version to your website. So if I go back to my website at the moment, it still says this because I've not refreshed the page. So let's just refresh the page then. And there you go. Now the page is refreshed and you don't have that warning any longer. And the PHP version now is fully up to date. And now all I need to do is to work through some other updates as well. So I've got an update to WordPress to do, and I've got a few other things to update on the plugins. But that's it, that's the solution. You now know how to update or fix the PHP update on your website, and hopefully that's enabled you to have a nice secure version of PHP that will now run your website for the next several years. Thanks for listening, and make sure you subscribe below, and hopefully I'll be speaking again to you soon.